Blessings, blessings. Yeah. You know I'm the Crocus bag farmer, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, blessings, blessings. Welcome to another cooking lesson. Ladies and gentlemen, you know I'm the Crocus bag farmer. Thank you for tuning in to my channel. And I have a special, special fruit right here. And I am going to produce a nice smoothie, a nice drink from this juice fruit right here. And as you see, it's a beautiful, beautiful fruit. Hopefully you can see it. It's beautiful and it's cute. Yes, that is the truth. It's a lovely aphrodisiac of mine. You know, it's beautiful, elegant. And if you know what it is, go ahead and leave your comment there. I'm going to be blending up the juice. And I have here, you know, some overripe bananas from the local grocery store. And, you know, I got these in the area where they're getting rid of the stuff that's too ripe. And I have some nutmeg and a little piece of cinnamon that I'll be grating in the smoothie. Now, if you have not guessed as yet, this fruit is called a custard apple. Custard apple, some people call it sugar apple. But it's really the sweet sap that's the sugar apple, and then you have the sour sap. But this is the mother or the grandmother of them all, the custard apple. And I'm going to juice this fruit right here, produce a nice creamy juice. Now, I have taken a second and prepared these two here. I have a tray here. Actually, let me use this plate. Hopefully you can see what I'm doing. I have this plate here and I'm going to break the custard apple apart, and then I'm going to use this fork, press it, and try to see if I could get out the seeds. Then I'll go move forward with the process and blend it in my blender, and I'll go then show you the delicious, delicious custard apple juice that I'm making. So, like I said, you know, you need a fruit, you need ripe banana, a little almond milk, nutmeg, a few spoons of brown sugar or honey. If you like to use honey, that's perfect. So, the custard apple, as you see, a beautiful fruit. I take the heart out. We practice in Jamaica to eat the heart. Because it's good for people who wet bed. Bedwetters. When we're small, we say that. So, like I said, you want to take the skin off. This is so nice and creamy. Amazing. So I'm going to get the skin off of it. And like we would do in Jamaica, I'm going to put it to the side here for a second. Because I am tempted. But because I'm on video right now, and it's not kosher, I cannot eat off the skin. I'm gonna put it to the side, and I will be full drawing the little pieces where they're on it. I'm telling you, it's like, you know, getting your favorite mango or so. You can't just throw away the skin. I'm going through that, but I wanted to show you how I deal with this, you know, kosher. As you see, I'm using the fork to mash it like this. And because it's ripe, it will get some of the skin out, some of the seed out. Because there are some seeds inside of these plumps here. Let me see if I could find one. Right here, there's a seed, and inside of it is a plump. I just washed my hand. See, some people use their hand and do it. And then there's a seed. So I'll be saving these seeds. See if I could catch the tree. There's a black seed right here. Right? It's a black seed right here. So, I'm trying to get them out because I want to blend up all these. So, all I'm doing is I'm mashing it with the fork. And then, I'm going to put some milk in it. So I could get the seeds to separate. Some people just blend it like that. When they do that, it break up some of the seeds. I'm trying to catch the seeds right now. And I did get this custard apple from my dad. Big up yourself, daddy. Happy love you. This product here, the custard apple, is good for good immune system. It's good for good eyesight. High in protein. Yes. And you know when you have high protein, you can roll a pea and mash it up, you see? Now I'm going to throw some milk on it. To like I create a little liquid that I could pour off. Get out the seed and that's it. So I just put it in here and I got a good almost a half bowl of custard apple. Throw some milk in it now, right? Stir it up, get it a little bit more liquid, throw that off, and then I'm gonna see if I could get some more out. Get the seeds out, because the whole point is to mash it up and separate the seeds from it. Throw some, I throw another organic almond in here to get some liquid going. Alright, I'm basically trying to liquefy it now. Yeah, as you see, I'm gonna use a fork and stir it now. But this is Rastafari soldier. I'm the Crocus bug farmer, people. If you have not seen this made before, yes, this is it. This is custard apple drink. It's a punch. It's just amazing. So now what I want to do is, I'm going to see if I can get a little bit more liquid in it. Then I'll strain off some and get back to mashing it out. Now blending the banana is gonna provide some more sweetness. My God, this is gonna be a delicious. I'm getting back to the skin of it. I'm eating that up. Oh, trust me. Oh, trust me. Hopefully it's enough liquid in here where I could pour this and it will, some of it will come through. Yep. Get the spoon out of the way. Some is coming through. See? Wow. Amazing. That is just unbelievable. Now people, that don't look delicious coming out there. My God, it's thick. So this process is to separate the seeds, you know, so I'm gonna go mash it again and then I'm gonna blend it. I wanna get out the seeds, because first of all, I wanna try catching the tree. Big up yourself, David. That is how you give it to him, you know. And I big up my daddy, Delarent, and cuz. And one day I always bring me things, you know. He called me the other day and say, yo, you home? I say, yeah. They want to come check. Me look, the big old custard apple, man. So I say, you know what? I have to video this because it's not. Many times I see a custard apple, first of all, that big. And right now I'm in South Florida area. But it's in foreign. Whoa! So, you know, I farm evening till the morning, anywhere I go. Yeah, seeds have to sow. The magic of it grow, I love it. All right, so, see I broke it down now to this amount. And I'm gonna go back to it now. Right, now I want you to see the texture in this. I don't want it to leak out, but my gosh, you see that, people? That is called. I don't even want to say it. Anyway, if you're low up on the sperm count, you got a good amount, full of protein, my friend. So now I'm just crushing, trying to see if I could get more of the seeds out. Get out the seeds. I'm going to throw some more milk in here so I get some more liquid. Seeds out the actual plump, there's a plump there and you have to get them out the seeds. So when you do like this with the spoon, like rubbing them, the separating. I could have just ate this, you know, but you know, I just wanted to show you what I'm doing is just you're cooking. Put your hand in it. Just make sure your hand's clean. Come on. We've been doing it for years. I don't know what's the difference now. So right now, I'm going to throw a little walk away. I'm just going to the friction because I don't have a second person videoing with me. Let's see if I can get. Right now, I'm not too worried about the thickness. I'm worried about getting all this. And I hope by me turn the milk on if you don't destroy the seeds. See? Another nice cream. Seeds, people. I need the seeds. I need them. I'm gonna put all of them in a pot and try planting them. One must grow. I'm realizing. Throw the milk on it. It's almond milk, so you can use any milk you want. A lot of people like to use condensed milk because it sweetens it differently. But I just use regular brown sugar on it. Delicious flavor. You can't eat the skin. Mm-mm. field. No way. So let me get back to cooking. I'm blending out this juice. Come in, when I leave, I'll comment that I'm eating out the food. But don't mind, leave your comment, please. Right, so I'm gonna leave, you know, put a little nutmeg in it, create a little flavor. Right, I have my grate over here. Have a look at this stuff. Cinnamon right here. I'm gonna put some in it. This is like seasoning it, you know? Seasoning it again. Tasted and I feel like I'm up there already. Up there. I'm talking about up there. it sweet. So I'm looking to get probably about a good 5 hours or 6. After it, I want to probably about this jar here full, which I should run a bit probably. Okay. I did say that I was thinking I'd put some oats in it, like some oatmeal, so
I don't know.
This one, I didn't put any sugar in it. It's really up to your loyalty to put whatever you sweetening you want in it. You understand? But I didn't put any sugar in it. I just used about 6 ripe bananas. You understand? Families and friends, as you see, the drink is ready and I pour it. Fortunately, my camera kind of stopped. And I'm telling you, this drink hit the spot. Really does hit the spot. Families, Rastafari soldier, thank you for tuning in. Hit the red subscribe button. Hope you're feeling full joy, the techniques. I wish I could give you some, to tell you the truth. You can link up to the Think and Think Up. Yes, this is very, 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 very good. Very good. Remember to subscribe.